Now that you have logged on to HubMeta, you're ready to create your first project and change the settings of that project. In this page, you can add a new project. Let's call it HubMeta Demo. And here you can choose a slug, which basically creates a link to your project. You can share this with others or use this to come directly to your project on HubMeta. And here you can upload a picture for your new project. Down here, you have the option to import a file from an existing project. The files that you can enter are either a .csv or .json or .HubMeta files. Usually those files are taken from HubMeta itself. So for example, this is a .HubMeta file, which I will show you in a minute how to create. This option is used when you want to duplicate an existing project or when you have created a backup from an earlier version of your project and now want to do some more work on it, or if you want to share all the information of your project with colleagues or other collaborators. So let's create a blank project. It gives me an error, says this slug already exists. Just a reminder that this should be a unique one. I will just add the number 2 here and create my project here. This is the new project. I'll make sure I will pin it so that it is shown up top. So if you open it up, this is how it looks the first time. Obviously, my project is still empty. So if I come down here into settings and go to general, here are a few things that you can change about your project. Some of these options we'll have to skip for now and explain later in other videos. But for now, you can change the name and slug or upload a picture. You can add a description. But down here in advanced, this is where you can export all the information from your project into a .HubMeta file. So basically, this takes all the information, including the articles, the correlations, the analysis that are saved, everything in your project. So if you click on Start Exporting, it will create a .HubMeta file. Just note that if this is a big project, this might take a few minutes, and you will be notified when HubMeta is done creating your file. Another point here is this file can only be used to recreate another project on HubMeta. If you're planning to take this file for analysis elsewhere, you use the second option, which is export correlations to a CSV flat file. This would export the correlation tables, all the correlations that are saved in your project as a CSV file. Then you can take it elsewhere and do all sorts of analysis like in R or in any other software that you have to do your analysis there. Down here, you can also archive your project and search LibMeta, which we will explain in another video. Now, let's take a look at the dashboard for your project.